idea behind our group. We put together artists and scientists, and we want to somehow do a better job of getting across to the public the message about what's happening to the planet, and particularly for us, the oceans. Scientists have done, I think, for the most part, not a very good job of communicating their science to the general public, and in part it's because it's very complicated stuff sometimes. But I think it's really a shame, and to me in particular, it was brought to my attention during the presidential debates earlier this year. It seemed like a large part of the general population just really doesn't understand what's going on with climate change and the things that are happening to our planet. And so we're hoping to engage people just in community by community and just like get everybody to like open their eyes and see what's going on, but in a way that isn't like the typical thing where a scientist puts up a bunch of graphs and uses nomenclature that no one in the audience can even understand to get across the point that they just give up on trying to.
Back in the water, but then we lived after that, and then I was so sad because I really wanted to keep it, but I didn't, and I wanted to make sure it wasn't have an owie, but we didn't see the owie, and that Jeffy said we have an owie, so he floated back in the water, but he didn't follow Verisar, so he couldn't swim back to his family, and I think he died.
And the ocean means a great deal to me because it's my sanctuary, and it's always been a playground for me. When I was a little girl, my mom used to take me to the beach about once a week, and I know that this will sound a little cheesy, but I always used to duck my head under the water, and I would whisper, I love the ocean, and that I felt God there. So it's definitely something that's really sacred to me.
People are missing the trash can, so the trash is going in the dump, which is leading to the ocean. And when the seagulls dive down for fish, they're getting plastic in their neck, and so they can't breathe and they suffocate.
Turtles are dying because people are putting plastic bags in the ocean. Turtles think that the plastic bags are jellyfish, so they eat it and they die.
I also made a short film about the things that we don't see. You know how when you dive into the water, it's kind of hard to see, but the fish can see it perfectly, but not too perfectly. So that little bag my friend was talking about earlier, the turtles think they're jellyfish, and when they eat that plastic bag, it kills them from inside out.
I do think fish have feelings. My husband and I were snorkeling in St. Thomas once and fed hundreds of beautiful tropical fish from our hands. And you could tell that they had personalities almost. It was one of the most fabulous things I'd ever done. And to this day, I remember that vacation very vividly. The fish were wonderful. It was the best part of the whole thing.
Wonder what's underneath the ocean, what is there, and it's such an imaginary beautiful thing. I see fish swimming around, I see life come, life beneath, and it's something that we all cannot see on a daily basis. It's quite hidden. What's happening down there is horrible right now. We're destroying it. It's something that is occurring, and it's just taking action and seeing the destruction of sea life, the fish, all the coral reefs that are being eliminated and dying. It just really, really breaks my heart. We are not doing enough to protect what we have. You know, without the ocean, I don't think we would be alive.
Scientists talking one language, policymakers and the general public like to see things in different terms, different types of graphs, different plots, different information. And there's been a big effort in the last 5 to 10 years that I'm aware of trying to get scientists and policymakers together, try and see what information does policymakers, what do they need, and how can we as scientists produce that to make their job easier? Because it's a very difficult job to take all this information, this huge amount of information, make some sense out of it, and then kind of forge a path of where should we go, what should we do, what laws to enact, what policy to make.